In this video, we're going to do example 7.7.4. Once a fire is reported to a fire insurance company, the company makes an initial estimate X of the amount it will pay to the claimant for the fire loss. When the claim is finally settled, the company will pay an amount Y to the claimant. The company has determined that X and Y, measured in thousands of dollars, have joint density function f of xy given here. Given that the initial claim estimated by the company is $2,000, calculate the probability that the final settlement amount is between $1,000 and $3,000. So this word problem will be an application of conditional distributions. So the first thing that we need to take stock of is that we are given something, which means here, so given the initial claim, that's x is equal to 2. So we have a conditional probability because we are given a value for one of the variables. We're asked to calculate the probability that the final settlement, that is y, is between 1 and 3,000. So we're asked to calculate the probability that 1 is less than y is less than 3, given that x is equal to 2. And so we know that we need to find a conditional distribution, and we're going to integrate that. So we'll need to integrate from 1 to 3 the density of y given that x is equal to 2 of y given x is equal to 2 dy. Now this density function we know is the joint density, so it's f of, well, 2 for x and y over the marginal f sub x evaluated at 2. So the first thing that we're going to need to do is find the marginal. Second, we will find the conditional density, and third, we will find the integral. So let's start with 1, the marginal. So to find the marginal density function for x, we need to integrate out the y, which means we need to integrate over the support of y of the joint density dy. Now that support, y is greater than 1, so that's like saying that we've got the integral from 1 to infinity of something here which looks a little monstrous, but it's actually not that bad when we sort of cut it down into little pieces and take a look at what's actually there. So we've got 2 over x squared times x minus 1, y to this fraction minus 2x minus 1 in brackets over x minus 1 dy. And when we integrate with respect to y, everything here is just a constant. So we just need to be careful with our algebra. So we are going to do a power rule, which means so we will have an antiderivative. Let's turn this improper integral into a limit. So the limit is t goes to infinity of, and then we're going to have 2 x squared times x minus 1, and we need y to a new power. So let's do that calculation on the side. We need to take the old power, and using the power rule, we need just to add 1 to it. So we need to do, let's multiply through that, negative 1 minus 2x over x minus 1, and to add 1 to it, we're going to add the denominator, which is going to be, so, plus x minus 1. The minus 1s are going to cancel, that is nice, minus 2x plus x, so I get minus x over x minus 1. That is the new power. So x minus x over x minus 1, and then of course with the power rule we need to divide by the new power, which is like multiplying by the reciprocal. So x minus 1 over minus x, and that is the antiderivative that we need to run from 1 to t. Now before we do that limit, let's clean stuff up a little bit. So x minus 1 will cancel with that x minus 1, and I can rewrite this as, so in terms of the limit, everything with x in it is a constant, so we'll bring those out into the front. So that's minus 2 over x cubed, x squared times minus x. And then we have this here, this limit, which involves y to this power running from 1 to t. So the limit, actually I don't need that bracket there. So the limit as t goes to infinity of, and then this evaluated at t, so t to the minus x over x minus 1, and minus 1 to that power, so 1. Now this, because x is greater than 1, this is a positive number, and so with a negative out in front, that is going to be a negative exponent, and as t goes to infinity, that will give me 0, and then we have negative 2 over x cubed times negative 1, so my marginal density is just 2 over x cubed, and that is going to be when x is greater than 1 and 0 otherwise. Okay, so there is the marginal for x. Now that is step 1 done. We need to then create the density function by taking this fraction. So our density function, f sub y given x is equal to 2 of y given x is equal to 2 is going to be, well, the joint density when I plug in 2. So let's see what happens there. I'm going to go 2, x is equal to 2, so I'm going to have 2 over 4 times 1. So 2 over 4 times 1, y to the, so y to the, and then I'm plugging in 2 again. So 4 minus 1 is 3 to the minus 3 over 2 minus 1 is 1. So there's our numerator, that's f of 2 and y. Now we've got to plug in 2 into f sub x, so that is going to be over 2 over 2 cubed, which is 8. A little bit of a cleanup here, so those 2's are going to cancel, and I will get 8 over 4 is 2, y to the minus 3, or 2 over y cubed. And that is going to be valid for when y is greater than 1, and of course that function will be 0 otherwise. So there is our conditional density function of y given x is equal to 2. So the last step to calculate this probability, now that we've got this distribution, is just to integrate. So let's do that, and we will be done. So the third step here, the probability that we're looking for, 1 less than y is less than 3, given x is equal to 2, is the integral from 1 to 3 of 2 over y cubed dy, which is, so we're looking for an antiderivative here, we're going to have 2 over y squared, and then divided by minus 2, so times 1 over minus 2, and this will be from 1 to 3, these will cancel, and so I will get, what do I have here, minus 1, 3 squared is ninth, minus minus is plus 1, or 8 ninths. All right, so that last step, right, once you've got the distribution, once you've got the density function, then you're just treating it like any other density function. The first thing that you have to recognize in a problem like this is that when the word given appears, that it is a conditional probability that you're looking for, and you have to use a conditional density function.